Hi guys, hope you're all well. This is Ulas. Today we'll be studying the structures under the cover of deltoid muscle. Okay guys, let's get started. Guys, we studied about the deltoid muscle last class. What is a deltoid muscle? Deltoid muscle is a muscle of the shoulder region which is from the taking origin from three bones and getting inserted into the deltoid tuberosity, isn't it? So if it is coming like that, the structures under the cover of it are basically the structures below it, isn't it? We'll be studying them under these settings: joints, bones, muscles, vessels, nerve, ligaments and bursae. Okay guys, what joint? See here, is there hip joint here, is there knee joint here, is there ankle joint here? No, it's the shoulder joint, the only one joint, small muscle, one joint, that is the shoulder joint, isn't it? What are the bones forming the shoulder joint? The clavicle, the scapula and the humerus, isn't it? The clavicle is not a part because anterior border is getting involved. If there was a posterior border, it would have covered the clavicle and then gone now. So that is not happening because anterior border muscle, so clavicle is not under the cover of it. What structures? Mainly the humerus, obviously, now the upper end of humerus is under the cover of it. Then scapula is a bone forming the shoulder joint, isn't it? So what part of scapula? Mainly the coracoid process, because muscle is coming like this, it is covering the coracoid process, which is here, isn't it? Then muscles, when we remember the bony structures under the cover of deltoid muscle, now guys, remembering muscles is very easy. How? See here, there is a muscle coming from 3, 4, 5 ribs and getting inserted into the coracoid process, isn't it? Which is that muscle? That is the beautiful pectoralis minor muscle. So if pectoralis minor muscle is inserted into the coracoid process and coracoid process is under the deltoid muscle, isn't the pectoralis minor muscle also under the deltoid, isn't it? So pectoralis minor muscle is under the cover of deltoid muscle. Then what? The sits muscle. Sits muscles are supraspinatus, infraspinatus, teres minor, subscapularis muscle. They are inserted, the sit muscles are inserted into the greater tubercle of humerus, the subscapularis muscle into the lesser tubercle of humerus. The tubercles of humerus are in the upper end of humerus. Upper end of humerus is under the cover of deltoid. So those muscles are under the cover of deltoid. Then another three beautiful set of muscles: the pectoralis major, the teres major and the latissimus dorsi muscle. Latissimus dorsi muscle, we call it the lady between two majors, isn't it? It is getting inserted into the bicipital groove. To the lateral lip is the pectoralis major, medial lip is the teres major, middle is the latissimus dorsi, isn't it? Those were the muscular insertions. Now there are origin of muscles also in those bony prominences. See here, coracobrachialis, in the name itself it is saying I am coming from the coracoid process and going into the brachium, coracoid process to the arm, isn't it? Then there is short head of biceps, which is taking origin from the coracoid process. Coracoid process under under deltoid, so the biceps also under deltoid. Then there is long head of biceps breaker. Where is it? It's in the supraglenoid tubercle. It is covering the shoulder joint now. Above shoulder joint is the supraglenoid tubercle. It is also under the cover of deltoid muscle. So by long head of biceps, short head of biceps, both under the cover of deltoid muscle. Okay. Then triceps. Triceps is a beautiful muscle. It has three heads, isn't it? Triceps, three heads, isn't it? So the long head, lateral head, medial head. See, the long head of triceps is taking origin from the infraglenoid tubercle. Biceps, supraglenoid. Triceps, infraglenoid. From the infraglenoid tubercle, it is also under the shoulder joint. Now it will also be under the cover of deltoid muscle, isn't it? Then there is the lateral head of triceps. Lateral head of triceps, where is it taking origin from? It is taking origin from the upper end of humerus. Upper end of humerus, under the cover of deltoid. What part of upper end? Above the spiral groove. Spiral groove is somewhere in the middle of the shaft of humerus. So if it is above it, in the upper end, it will also be under the cover of deltoid. So long head, lateral head of triceps, whole biceps is under the cover of deltoid muscle, isn't it? Then there are vessels. What vessels? Achha and pacha. Where are they? Around the surgical neck of humerus, isn't it? Achha and pacha are around the surgical neck of humerus. So achha is what? Anterior circumflex humeral artery. Pacha is posterior circumflex humeral artery. Only arteries will be there? No. Usually veins will accompany artery in such cases. So veins. Anterior circumflex humeral vein, posterior circumflex humeral vein. So those were the vascular structures around the surgical neck of humerus. Surgical neck of humerus under the cover of deltoid muscle. So they are also under the cover of deltoid now. Then there's a beautiful nerve here. What nerve? That is the axillary nerve. We'll be studying that in detail soon. Then there is beautiful set of tendons that is forming the musculotendinous cuff, the sits muscles. Supraspinatus, infraspinatus, teres minor, subscapularis. Then there is coracoacromial ligament. See guys, coracoacromial ligament is here. If you palpate, this is the coracoid process, this is the acromion. It is between here. But if you touch it, you won't feel the ligament in the beginning because there is muscle there. So if the deltoid muscle is there, it is under the cover of retina, isn't it? So that is why coracoacromial ligament is under the deltoid muscle, under the cover of deltoid muscle. Then there is bursa. What is bursa? It is like a balloon, water-filled balloon. What is the balloon made of? Balloon is the synovial membrane. What is inside? Inside the balloon is the synovial fluid. So why is it? Because tendons or muscles are moving over bone. Na? Bones are hard. So if they rub, the muscle tendon will tear off if it rubs like this. So they are putting a water balloon so that there is some less friction between the bone and the muscle. Isn't it? So the reason what bursae are around the shoulder joint is many are there. Chiefly, all bursae are under the cover of deltoid, but chiefly there are two bursae, which is that subacromial bursa, because it is under acromion process. Acromion process is under the cover. Like if it is below the acromion, it is obviously under the cover of deltoid muscle. Then there is subdeltoid. In the name only, it is saying I am below deltoid. So that is under the cover of deltoid muscle. These were the structures under the cover of deltoid muscle, guys. Importances can be during intramuscular injection, we might injure the axillary nerve. Which is under the cover of deltoid, we might even injure the vessels, which may cause some hematoma in there. Guys, this was today's class. If you have any doubts, please post it in the comment section. I'd be happy to answer you guys. Take care. See you.